I'm your host, Michelle Dudash. I'm really excited for today. We're talking about guacamole, but not just any guacamole. We're here with my good friend, Kristen Barber, who's also my neighbor, and she makes an amazing guacamole. This is not an exaggeration. I feel like I can come out and say that because I've been to Mexico many times. I lived in Arizona for 15 years, so when I taste a good guacamole, I know it. Let's get to it.
How do we make this? Okay, well, first, that's very flattering. Thank you for saying that. I know you know your food. So, we're going to start with avocados here. Uh-huh. So what I do is I just keep it simple. I use a bowl that you find in your kitchen okay. and just one spoon.
A spoon? Yeah. That's interesting. I've never seen anyone. Why do you use a spoon?
I use a spoon. You can start mashing. I'll do a little more mashing here. Okay. But it keeps your avocados chunky, which is how I like my guac.
I like it too.
So it looks like you can eat it for a meal.
Yum.
So
I could eat guac for a meal.
Yeah.
Easily.
So you just kind of use your spoon and kind of chop it up so you get like a nice consistency, not too creamy. Just keep it chunky.
Okay. I like it.
Yep. Just kind of give it a nice mix here. Mm-hmm. And then next we'll do some Roma tomatoes.
Okay.
So we'll dump that in there.
And why do you use Romas versus, I mean, there's so many tomatoes. Why do you like Romas?
Yeah. So Roma tomatoes, they're not as juicy as the beef steak, whatever the technical term is for that. But it just dices better. It's not as watery. And so, same thing, the idea of keeping it chunky.
Okay. Yeah, but it's true because some tomatoes, they do make your guacamole too watery. I have noticed that for sure.
Yep.
Okay. And then
just kind of mix it.
Okay.
And then onions next.
White onion. Okay.
Again, diced. Chunky style. You don't have to get too fine with this.
That is chunky. And I will say, a lot of times I'd be afraid to put in onion, but whenever I try yours, I'm like, you know what? I'm glad there's diced onion in this. It's like, I like it bigger like that.
Yeah. So I think,
do like the texture.
Again, you're just kind of mixing it at this point. Because since you've already done the mashing of the avocados.
Yep. Okay.
Cilantro.
Yummy.
I like a good cilantro in here. Gives it that fresh taste.
Okay. And you know what else is interesting?
Yeah. Oh. Go ahead.
Oh, I was going to say, I used to always put a ton of spices in mine, but I noticed you keep it pretty simple with
just some kosher salt.
Okay.
And really, I just take a few pinches, toss it in there, and I kind of taste as I go too, just so you're making sure you're getting the right ratios.
Sure.
And then just some garlic powder here.
Okay.
Just going to dump that in there.
Now, do you ever use fresh or do you always use garlic powder?
So I kind of go back and forth just depending on the situation. My husband actually prefers a more fresh garlic taste, and so sometimes I'll put some garlic powder, but then also maybe put a clove or two in there to give it that real garlic taste.
Yeah.
So I think, you know, if you're going to a party and you don't want that garlic breath all night, sometimes I'll hold back on that and just do the garlic powder.
Okay.
But again, it's kind of really up to you and what you prefer.
Sure. That makes total sense. Yeah.
So once, you have everything in there, the last thing I do is just some lime juice.
Okay. You want me to help?
Oh, and some pepper as well.
Yep.
Perfect. Some pepper, cracked pepper here.
Is that good?
Yep.
Is that
and
a good
then
amount? Okay.
Just squeeze about half a lime in there.
Yum. Oh, this looks so good. I mean, this is like a salad I could just eat.
Yep.
Okay, perfect.
Again, give it one final mix.
Yummy.
That nice chunky guacamole.
Chips here. These are just mine, by the way. I don't know what you're having for lunch, but.
And then find a good little chip and dip plate and go ahead and plate it.
Perfect. That looks amazing. I'm going to dig into this.
Super easy.
So this recipe, by the way, you could just grab it right below. We have the full recipe. And here, let me grab a seal and stick a little bite here. Today, I'm Michelle Dudash. We will see you next time.
Good?
That is so good. You guys have to make this. Okay, guys. We'll see you next time. Bye.